May the Father of mercies, the God of all consolation, be with you and with your spirit. In the waters of baptism, Mary Gannon died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
I'm sorry that I left you. I know you feel alone, but God told me that He needed me. He called me to come home. It would seem to be an instant in the twinkling of an eye. An angel gently took my hand and led me. As I ascended into heaven, beyond the pearly gates, angels were rejoicing that I saw His radiant face. God's eyes shone down upon me by the glory of His throne. He said, enter into paradise, 'cause heaven now you're home. I fought the fight, I finished the race. Throughout the trial, I kept my faith. No longer do I suffer, my body's been made whole. I'm flying with
May Christ, who died for you, deliver you from eternal death. May Christ, the Son of the living God, set you down in the fresh beauty of His paradise. May He, the Good Shepherd, claim you as one of His flock. May He forgive you all your sins and grant you a place among the elect at His own right hand. There may you ever behold your Redeemer face to face, and ever stand before Him enraptured by the beauty of truth itself and placed in the ranks of the blessed. May you delight in the vision of our God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Lord Jesus, we pray, you alone are the Holy One and compassionate. Forgive Mary Gannon, the Geraghty, her sins. By dying, you open the gates to eternal life for those who believe in you. Do not let our sister be parted from you, but by your glorious power, grant her the light and the peace and the joy of your eternal kingdom. You live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the prayers of Mother Mary, the Mother of Jesus, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, console those who mourn for Mary Gannon. May she give them the comfort and consolation of her own faith, and by her prayers, lead them on to the happiness of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God, who made the union of man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and the Church, grant peace and mercy to Mary, who was united in love with her now departed husband, Paddy. May the care and devotion of her life on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on all her family and friends now gathered here, and as they turn to you for your compassion and love, strengthen their faith in your everlasting goodness and kindness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for a moment. Please be seated. Just a word of welcome to each and every one of you. On behalf of the Gannon family, to this church, of the Church of Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception. Mary Gannon will be sadly missed. Her unexpected and sudden death at her home. She Kilgalligan will miss a wonderful woman of faith and a wonderful mother. Kilgalligan and Carrowteigue will miss and are a great loss for Mary. And we join together in our prayers for the sacrifice of the Mass for the repose of her soul. And we join our prayers with for to comfort all our family, for our son Porrick and our daughters Caroline and Regina and Connie, and our brothers Mickey and Sean, and our sisters Bridie and Bridie O'Malley and Annie Curley and Lily Coyle, and our brother-in-law John Gannon, and our sister-in-law Bridie O'Sullivan, and our five grandchildren Luke, Aveen, Sarah, Katie and Ada, and our sons-in-laws and our daughter-in-law and our nieces and nephews and relatives, neighbours and all the friends. We welcome you all here today and all that have sympathised at the house and at this sad, in their sadness, all the friends and neighbours that have travelled to be here. And I welcome too those that will be joining us in the recording of this Mass later on. I welcome you and thank you for taking the time, and thank you for your prayers for the family and for all here. We join us in this Mass together, and I welcome Father Michael Nallon. And so, in our prayers and our consolation for the family and our grief and sadness, before we begin our Mass, to a few personal things that were important to Mary in her life, I invite now Martina to say a few words, and these items will be brought up to the altar before we begin. Thank you, Martina. Thank you. Right. Yes, thank you.
James brings bag of tato. Mary always had a bag of tato and seven up for the neighbouring kids, in particular Sophie and James, when they jumped the wall for a visit. Mickey carries Mary's and Paddy's radio. Mary listened to Radio na Gaeltachta, a Midwest radio, every day, and sometimes never turned it off for the entire day. She loved to hear all the news and listen to any music being played. Johnny brings Mary's rosary beads. Mary had a deep faith and went to Mass every Saturday and was devoted to God. She had a great belief in the power of prayer. Aveen brings her nanny's headscarf. She never left the house to go to the shed or anywhere else without it. Family photo is carried by Siobhan. Mary always worked hard to make sure everyone was taken care of and always put everyone else before herself. Sharon brings Mary's apron and a potato. Mary was always making food for somebody, and if you went anywhere near the sink, she would say, "Put an apron on you." She was a great woman for the dinners and was only happy when everyone was fed. The dinner was her way of making sure everyone was cared for.
Our entrance prayer for this Mass. May the Lord open to her the gates of paradise, that she may return to that homeland where there is no death and where eternal joy endures forever. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. and the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Welcome as we begin our Mass for Mary, for the happy repose of her soul, in our sadness and grief, and yet in thanksgiving for the wonderful mother and the wonderful woman she was in our faith and in our life. So we pause and we ask God's grace and God's blessing and God's forgiveness too for our own failures, and asking, Lord, to strengthen our faith and bless us. We pray together. Adrim the Eel, a Kukta, was there, Sharkarja, Gafaki made a thrum, the Sween of the Breer, Leniv of the Folly, Trumahor Fain, Trumahor Fain, Trumahor Fain, Aran Arbishin, Impiv, Nivuri Shiroi, Aran Angel of the Arniv, of the Rive Sharkarja, Kamakan, and Chirnagia, Gajani Deal Kukta of Troker, and Gamai Shir Bakidun, Gadresha, Kanapahi Shiri Shin. Lord Jesus, by your passion and death on the cross, you forgive us our sins. A here and a gentrocra. Lord Jesus, by your resurrection and ascension into the kingdom of heaven, you have opened the way to eternal life. A creus gentrocra. And Lord Jesus, by your blessed mother, Mary, and the comfort of the Holy Spirit, you give us the consolation of the truth and comfort those who mourn. A here and a gentrocra. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, who have strengthened us by the mystery of the cross, and promise us a share in your Son's resurrection, mercifully grant, we pray, that your departed servant, Mary Gannon, may be gathered into the company of your chosen ones, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Now, Fionnuala and Brian are going to give us the readings, and Tommy Chapman is the psalm. Thank you.
I read you from the prophet Isaiah. Fear not, I am with you. Be not dismayed. I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you and uphold you with my right hand of justice. For I am the Lord your God who grasps your right hand. It is I who say to you, fear not, I will help you. I have brushed away your offences like a cloud, your sins like a mist. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. Can a mother forget her infant, or be without tenderness for the child within her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you. See, upon the palm of my hand I have written your name. Yes, in joy you shall depart, in peace you shall be brought back. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I watch the sun rise, lighting the sky, casting its shadows near. And on this morning, bright though it be, I feel shadows near me.
Reading from the first letter of St. John, think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Speak, O Lord, your servant here is listening. You have the words of everlasting life. Speak. Words of everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." It's the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for a moment. That Gospel of John, it's a beautiful Gospel. It's a beautiful Gospel, and there are beautiful readings. They're words of consolation. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not let your hearts be trust in God. And when Jesus spoke that Gospel, it was about before his own death. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And there are many rooms in my Father's house. I'm going now to prepare a place for you. And that's a place for each and every one of us. And then he says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to the Father except through me." Jesus is the great mediator between humanity and the next world to come. He's the great mediator that opens his arms to embrace and to love. And that's Jesus in this Gospel. And the beautiful readings we heard before that. If a mother would forget her child, "I will never forget you." Imagine. God, we sometimes think of God as a great man up in the heavens, but God is like a mother and a father. I'll never forget you. Even if a mother would, imagine a mother forgetting her child, "I will never forget you. I will embrace you." And then the second reading, think of the love that's lavished on us because we're God's children by the sacrament of baptism, the certainty that we belong to Christ. God, Mary belonged to belong to her family and to Paddy, her husband, but she also belongs to God. And this Mass, we're giving her back to God so that she'll be with Paddy and God forever and waiting for us then. And, you know, she, as we heard, she came to Mass every Saturday evening, the Vigil Mass for Sunday. And last Saturday evening, when in the Gospel, Jesus says in the Gospel, he said, last Saturday, he said, if anybody wants to be the greatest among you, they must be the servant of all. And Mary Gannon certainly served her family and all she knew so wonderfully and so beautifully. She in her kindness and her love for you, Porrick, and for Connie and Regina and Caroline, as a mother, an irreplaceable love. And that's why you're sad and grieving today, because she's taken from you so sudden and so unexpectedly, but at home with her family. But and then she's the greatest of grandmother for her beautiful Luke and Aveen and Katie and Sarah and Ada. Isn't that right? The grandmother, a grandmother's love for you all. And then a beautiful, kind, loving sister to her family, to Bridie and to Annie and Lily and our two brothers, Mikey and Sean. Isn't that right? And so, and a godmother to David in her love, and many others. You know her better than me, because she's your own flesh and blood. And to her other our friends, our sons-in-law, daughter-in-law, and all the many nieces and nephews. There'll be a great loss, surely, because she was loved by all. A mother, we were honouring her memory at this Mass, and yet you don't want to let her go, but that's God's will. God's way, God's universal eternal truth, and God's eternal life is what we accept in this Gospel. And you know, it said there in the Gospel, there are many rooms in my Father's house, and surely there was many rooms in the heart of Mary Gannon, many rooms in the Gannon family home, the room of welcome inside the door, the room of hospitality in the kitchen where everybody would be fed and nobody would go hungry, and the room of prayer. When you go from the hallway to the kitchen, the beautiful Sacred Heart picture over the door to bless, to remind us of that love of God from the heart of Christ, that eternal love that blesses us and reminds us of our eternal destiny. And that's why we're in sadness and despair, and yet we don't despair, because we know that a woman of a big heart, her love is not extinguished when this life comes to an end, because she's sharing the spirit of the risen God, her life is not ended but transformed into a new way, into a new presence in that God's kingdom. We give thanks today for a woman of great faith, a woman of prayer, and a smile that you'll miss around Kilgalligan, but we have to lift ourselves up and continue and know that she's with you in a new way, in a special way, in our prayers, for as a mother and grandmother and sister and an aunt and friend and neighbour. There were tears, but the Lord changes our sorrow into joy. The Lord will change our words into words of song. The Lord will change the bread and wine to become the body and blood of Christ. The Lord will change our mortal bodies to be transformed into copies of God's glorious body. That's the way it is. That's our trust in the living and risen from the dead. That's our trust in God. And it was a beautiful thing to be at the house and in her departing from this life, and to pray the last rites of the church for Mary in the grief and sadness that abounded in the house. But yet, and when I you know, I had to, afterwards I had to come back to Cornboy because we had Eucharistic adoration in the church and we had Mass at 7 o'clock. And as I knelt and sat and prayed before the altar, I remembered, it came into my mind, another beautiful picture, the picture of Paddy and Mary on their wedding day over 50 years ago, 1970, 51 years of married life. The picture, this church didn't exist then. There they were, the happiest day of their life, the youngest and most beautiful, joyful couple on their beginning of their wedding day. That's the way we should picture them now, together for all eternity in the happiness of God's glorious kingdom. No tear, only waiting for us to join. We join in the prayer at Mass. And so waiting patiently, we wait patiently too, and in our prayers, and nourished by the word of God, strengthened by our sacraments in the Mass, and knowing that there were before the altar, and there they are before the glorious presence of God, united forever in the joy and the happiness in the kingdom of heaven, which all that has come before us. And that's why we can pray with confidence, eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May their souls, souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. I invite those now that are joined the prayers of the faithful for Mary and all the family here. I invite them to come forward and we pray our prayer for them. We thank you. Well done. We pray, Lord, at this Mass, we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Saviour and Redeemer, who has opened the way to everlasting life. And so it's with confidence that we bring our prayers to God our Father.
We pray for Mary, who leaves us in death, that God our Father will lead her safely home and give her the joys of the eternal kingdom in heaven, of happiness and peace. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As we thank God for Mary's life, we remember her with love and affection, and that we may all seek to serve God and each other in the church and in our parish. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all the sick, the elderly, and those who care for those at home or in hospital. May they all know the strength of Christ's presence with them in their time of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We give thanks for the gift of our baptism and all the gifts that you, Lord, have bestowed on these members of our family and our parish. We ask you, Lord, to bless them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We remember all the deceased members of the Gannon and Geraghty families and all those we have loved and cherished and all those with no one to remember them. May God welcome them into the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. We pray, Lord, that we've come to this holy place, Lord, God of mercy and love and strength. Look kindly on your servant, Mary Gannon, having been faithful throughout her life. May you give her now the fullness of joy and peace and a place in your kingdom with her husband, Paddy, and with Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
My dead hand, sitting.
Blessed are you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Through the mystery of this water and wine, we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. God, with humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As the praise and glory of his name, our good and good of all his holy church. Prayer over the offerings. Mercifully receive, we pray, O Lord, the offerings we trustingly present for the soul of your servant, Mary Gannon, that through this sacrifice, which you ordained as the one true remedy for all, may grant her everlasting salvation and peace through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, Lord, for your faithful, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with all the angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, the pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
That Jesus Christ.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and John our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant, Mary Gannon, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed husband Paddy, our son Anthony, Lizzie, all the deceased members of their families, all the departed brothers and sisters, all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you for all ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
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 Amen. Guimish Kalanar, Fimur, Hunash Lonio, Dunier, we say it together. Or Nahar. Beneath for the dog of the reed, but yet retailer and tall of more the internet, or Roman Lehu, Tord and a new and a vehicle. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of power.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the risen Lord be with you always. And we pray together, Aounje, Togus Pakian down, Gentrocher. Aounje, Togus Pakian down, Gentrocher. Aounje, Togus Pakian down, Tordun, Shishikon. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Nice to me. You always give me biscuits. You are always thoughtful too. I miss you. I also love you. I hope you are having a nice time with Papa. From Sarah.
We rarely spoke about death, but the few times we did, Mum would say, "Now, when I go, don't be going up talking about me. Just get on with it." But it just didn't seem fitting to let her go without a reflection on her life. She was very practical and didn't really like attention. She wanted things just so and without any fuss with regard to herself. Mum was devoted, particularly to our father, Paddy, to us, to the grandkids, and recently more so to John. She watched over him and minded him daily since he came home from the hospital. Last night, Lily said, nobody could accuse Mary of being lazy. The truth is, she was always doing something and never afraid to turn her hand to a bit of hard work. Mom was born in Kilgalligan, August 21st, 1942. She went to school in Carrowteigue, later going to work in England and New York. She returned home and married Dad on the 7th of October, 1970, and they lived in Kilgalligan the remainder of their lives. Somebody said last night that they never thought Mom was 79, because she was always out and about doing jobs, and the truth is, we never really saw her as older because that part of her never changed. She just ploughed on no matter what. Sometimes we'd say it had to be done her way, whether it was putting on the fire or peeling spuds for dinner. If you tried to do it, she'd say, you're not doing that right. Give it to me. In the end, we said, sure, if you haven't the FOSS course done in the fire lighting and peeling, forget about it. She won't let you at it. Sunday dinner would kick off at 8 a.m, and if she saw you put your hand on the door handle, you'd get, where are you going now? The dinner will be ready soon. But really, that meant 5 hours later. And then the rattling would start with the pots. And all you'd see is the looks from Porrick and Derek and John James and Damien when they were trying to watch a game, and all you'd hear was the clattering. The pot walloping competition, John James used to call it. But her only goal was to feed everyone. When anyone called for a visit, she'd nearly tie them to the chair until they ate something. It was just her way. Kira McGrath said to me last night, the battles we had about sheep, and she had to get the last word, but we'd be friends again in the morning, and she'd call me up to the wall. They'd have it all forgotten about again the next day. Mom left us very suddenly. No fuss at all. And to be honest, looking back, none of us really realised that when Dad was gone, so was her true purpose in life. The rest of us had our daily routines and work, but he was her routine and her entire life. And honestly, she was never the same once he was gone. She would only say, oh, I don't know. But what she really meant was, life was just not the same without him. Her true purpose had left, and she never really thought she would be without him. Her sudden departure was really a gift for her, and we have to be grateful for that. It doesn't lessen the pain for anyone left behind, but we need to be thankful now that she wasn't sick and she didn't suffer. They're together now again, back to the beginning when it was just the two of them. May they rest in peace for eternity. We'd really like to thank our neighbours and our friends who were there for us last year and have gone above and beyond again this week. You've helped us so much, and we're so, so grateful to have you as neighbours and friends. Go on home, Mum. Dad is waiting for you now. God bless.
Troubles neglect you, and heaven accept you when it's time to go home. May you always have plenty, your glass never empty, and on your bed you're never alone. Never alone, never alone. I will be every beat of your heart when you face the unknown. Wherever you fly, this isn't goodbye. My love will follow you, stay with you, baby, never alone. May your tears come from laughing, your friends find worth having, and every year passing, they're worth more than gold. May you win and stay humble, smile more than grumble, and know when you stumble, you're never alone. Never alone, never alone. I will be every beat of your heart in the face.
Thank you, Sarah, and thank you, Caroline, and thank you all. And now, let us pray. Let us pray. The communion prayer, everything that the Father gives me will come to me, says the Lord, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Renewed by this life-giving sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of our sister Mary Gannon, to whom you gave a part in your covenant, may be purified by the power of this mystery and rejoice forever without end in the peace of your kingdom in heaven through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And I invite you to stand for the final Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Mary, and now we come to this last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall joyfully greet Mary Gannon again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. And we'll sing the little refrain, the response. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her forever. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Mary in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give thanks to you for all the blessings you bestowed upon her in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ. And we are with you and our sister forever. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. And may you enjoy God's kingdom forever. In peace now, let us take our sister to our place of rest.
This world is not my home, I'm just a passenger. Treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Goodbye, my old friend. Your troubles are now over. Rest your weary bones.
there's nothing left to do. Farewell, my old companion. You will be remembered. And as you leave this world, I thought the world of you. For that was in your heart. You carried on your shoulder part of your old hand, is embedded in the past. Let go of it all. No more tears or laughter. You're ready for the road that takes you home at last. And goodbye, my old friend. Don't be afraid, I'm with you. I'll guide you to the light. Your restless heart set free, and parting holds such pain. There may be no tomorrow. Dreams inside your heart will all come true for me. And goodbye, my old friend. I have to let you go now. You were the gentle breeze that light upon my way. I know you won't be far. That angel on my shoulder. So goodbye, my old friend. We'll meet again someday. So goodbye, my old friend. We'll meet again someday.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, our sister Mary Gannon, née Geraghty, goes now to a rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. And with faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with Mary together. May we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read from sacred scripture. Our true homeland is in heaven, and Jesus Christ, whose return we long for, will come from heaven and save us. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. O God, by whose mercy the faithful departed find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it as we bury here the body of our sister Mary Gannon. Deliver her soul from every bond of sin, that she may rejoice in you with your saints forever. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so you made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant our sister may sleep in the peace of Christ until you awaken her in glory. And we pray, Lord Jesus, because you have chosen to call our sister from this world to her to yourself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus will raise our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. Let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord embrace her in peace and raise her up on the last day. We pray, in the sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend her to the earth. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance to her and give her peace. We pray, Lord, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, God is the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life. Give eternal life to our sister Mary. We pray, and the response is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you console Mary and Martha in their distress. Draw near to those who mourn. Dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Comfort us, Lord, in our sorrow at the death of Mary. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are buried in this cemetery. Lord, grant them increasing joy and the light of glory on them, and forgive them their faults and failures, and may they rest in peace. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray together in the words our Saviour gave us. Or Nahar Atonyav, Gunyatran Hanam, Gunagatruit, Gunyatran Hanam, Yantran Tarav, Or on Lehul, Tordan and you. Watch with the Hunafin, Snalik Shigar Shirshin Oga Ulk. We pray. God of all holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Mary. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your holy will. As her faith united her to your people here on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels and saints, and with her husband Paddy in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Loving God, from whom all life proceeds, and by whose hand the dead are raised again, though we are sinners, you wish always to hear us. Accept the prayers we offer in sadness for your servant. Deliver her soul from death. Number her among your saints. Clothe her with the robe of salvation to enjoy forever the delight of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who pray to you in their need. Strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the prayers of Mary, the mother of Jesus, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help all those who mourn for Mary Gannon and accompany all of us in our time of need. We pray together, eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Now we'll pray the glorious mystery of the Rosary, the Resurrection. So we pray the glorious mystery. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Near Aran Mór, in the county Galway, one pleasant evening in the month of May, I spied a damsel. She was fair and handsome, and her beauty nearly took my breath away. For she wore no jewels or costly diamonds, no paint or powder, no, none at all. But she wore a bonnet with a ribbon on it, and round her shoulder was the gold we shone. We kept on walking, and she kept on talking, till her father's cottage, it came into view. She said, "Come in, sir, and meet my father. Should play to please him the foggy dew." She wore no jewel our costly diamonds, no paint nor powder, no, none at all. But she wore a bonnet with a ribbon on it, and round her shoulder was the gold we shone. It was early, early, all in the morning, I hit the road for old Donegal. And she said, "Goodbye, sir." She cried and kissed me, but my heart remained with the gold we shone. Oh, she wore no jewels our costly diamonds, no paint nor powder, no, none at all. But she wore a bonnet with a ribbon on it, and round her shoulders was the gold we shone. and round her shoulders was the gold we shone.